annoying, most annoying.
But the candles were new and hard to light. Probably a flawed manufacture. Also, most likely my wretched body. Longer and longer.
I believe you wanted to talk to me this morning.
Oh, yes. In fact, it was rather urgent.
How?
Well, when I told you a few weeks ago that I couldn't fall asleep at night because of the pain, you suggested that I do some reading, Pastor.
I remember, yes.
You distracted my mind. I started on the gospel. They were almost as good as sleeping pills.
Oh, really?
Yes, off and on. Off and on. Now I'm up to the story of Christ's suffering on the cross. I began to think seriously about it. So I said to myself, I must talk this over with Pastor Erickson. Suffering on the cross. Pastor. But surely it must be wrong to talk about Christ's suffering. Don't you think so?
Exactly what do you mean?
We all talk too much about the actual torture, it seems to me. But it can't have been all that bad. Yes, forgive me, I realize it sounds quite presumptuous. I think in my way that I have endured physical suffering that was equally as great as the suffering of our Lord Jesus Christ. And besides, his agony was fairly short. 4 hours at the most. Is that right? Yes. I thought that I saw a much greater suffering behind the tortures. Why? You'll say I've got it all wrong, maybe. But just think of Gethsemane, Pastor. All the disciples were sleeping. Not one of them had understood it. Not the last supper, not anything at all. And then when the Roman soldiers came, the disciples fled. And then Peter, who denied him. For 3 years, Christ had talked to these disciples. They had lived together all that time. Yet they hadn't understood a word. Then they all deserted. And then Jesus was left all alone. Pastor, how greatly he must have suffered then. To understand, no one understands. To be deserted at the very moment you need somebody you can rely upon. No suffering can ever exceed that. No. But even that wasn't the worst of all. When Jesus was nailed to the cross by the soldiers and he hung there in terrible agony, he cried out, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? He cried out as loud as he could. He thought that his Father in heaven had abandoned him. He believed that all his teaching was a horrible lie. Christ was struck by doubt just before he died. Pastor, that must have been when he suffered most. I mean by God's silence.
Yes.
Thank you. Reflex.
Thanks to the darkness to appreciate the light. I cry for you. I kneel and pee at all hours and grieve for your soul that moved away from me abruptly.
Thank you.
I pour rivers of blood into your lifeless heart and fall back exhausted. There I lay wasted while you walk away reborn.
Thank you. Thank you. downstairs. No, there's several of them downstairs.
Yeah.